Listen up, women, and you guys might learn something too. There are dating services to help women find men. There are personal ads. Bookstores have shelves devoted to finding, pleasing, and keeping a man. And the book, The Rules, tells women how to get a man without even being particularly nice to him. But when all of this stuff works, sometimes you have another problem. And that is why Ellen Ladowski is sitting in our Washington bureau. She is co-author of How to Dump a Guy, a Coward's Manual. Ellen, thanks for joining us this morning.
It's a pleasure to be here.
You know, it's funny. I always thought that men were the ones that had the problem because they would be passive-aggressive and they really wouldn't take action. But you think that it's women that have the problem.
I do. Women are incredibly cowardly when it comes to dumping guys. I mean, part of it is that there's a lot of pressure on women to be with a guy, any guy, and they don't want to be alone. And part of it is they don't want to hurt the guy's feelings.
Mm-hmm. Let's get personal, shall we? Let's talk about things that you probably never wanted to talk about on network TV.
Definitely not.
Let's talk about your dating relationships. Did you have this problem?
I did. I mean, before we wrote the book, I was like most women, you know. I just had a lot of trouble breaking up with guys. I was never definitive enough. So I would always, you know, qualify the breakup in some way. Like say, you know, maybe we should start seeing other people as well as, you know, continue to see each other. Or I just need some space right now. Absolutely.
Yeah. Now, are you better now that you've written the book and you have all these guidelines and things, which we'll get to in a minute?
I am. And in fact, while we were writing the book, we had a bit of a test kitchen going on at my co-author's house, which is where we wrote the book. Uh-huh. And, you know, during the course of the year, I was asked out by, you know, a few people, and I had to, well, I would say reject them, really, mm-hmm. after a few dates. And mm-hmm. so we tried out some of our lines, you know, and we were able to figure out which ones worked and which ones didn't work that well, and it was a good experience. Little field research.
Let me tell, bet the guys love that, or hearing that now, let me tell some of our viewers about your chapters. How to Know When to Go, Getting in Touch with Your Inner Coward, Klingons, Another Difficult to Dump Men, The Kindler, Gentler Ditch, and this is one of my favorites, actually, The Ditching Hour, Scheduling Your Breakup. I must admit, something I really hadn't thought of before. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Well, we just point out that the best time to dump a guy is on Friday night between 7 and 8 o'clock. And there are lots of reasons for this. I mean, you're not disturbing him at work. You know, he's
kind
not,
of you.
Yes, he's not calling you back at your place of work. You know, he has the whole weekend to lick his wounds. And, you know, if you wrap it up quickly, you can squeeze in a date that very evening.
cold, but funny. Also, what I thought was kind of interesting here, and I can't believe somebody actually did this, dumping by fax.
Oh,
somebody
it's amazing.
Actually dumped somebody by the fax machine that
yeah,
you know?
We counsel against this, actually, in our book. You know, unless you're dating a workaholic and it's your only way of reaching him.
Uh-huh. But you really knew somebody that did that, right?
Oh, absolutely.
And here's what the fax said, not coming for the weekend. And by the way, I think we should break up, Shelley.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Cold.
We were shocked.
Yes, I can imagine. How about this one, elements of a good exit line. What do you think are some of the best lines?
Well, the whole thing about an exit line is you want to make sure that it's not a cliche. So, you know, the usual line, it's not you, it's me, you know, horrible. And it insults the dumpy's intelligence. And it's usually, you know, preceded by something like, don't take this personally. Well, there's no other way to take it but personally. Mm-hmm. Another thing about an exit line is, you know, total honesty is not always the best policy when it comes to breaking up. You know, the best exit lines have the whiff of honesty, but not the stench of truth.
Okay.
So, you know, if you're fooling around with another guy, it's not necessary to tell this to your dumpy. That information is best left for your psychiatrist.
Okay. Here, a couple other lines that you mentioned here. I'm a little confused about my sexual orientation. If true, this is unbeatable, you say in the book. And trust me, I'm so screwed up, you really don't want to be with me. That's not a bad one.
No. I mean, the sexual orientation one, there are some drawbacks there, right? Because, you know, he may say something like, hey, that's cool, can I watch?
He may say that, or he, you know, might spread the word around. If it's not true, then it could be an issue.
Right.
You know, what do guys think about this book?
Guys love it. It's amazing. I mean, guys have really been snapping it up, and it shocked us at first. I mean, we thought, well, maybe they want to learn our trade secrets, or I don't know, maybe they just want to get it off the shelves or something so their girlfriends can't find it.
Warning signs. They're looking for warning signs. That's what I would think.
Possibly. And so, we do give them some help by telling them, you know, how they know the ditch is coming.
That's true. That's nice of you. Do you plan to write another one, How to Dump a Gal?
We were actually thinking something along the lines of How to Jump a Guy. Seemed like the easiest way to go. We could just change all the D's to J's.
You're going
to
leave women alone. You know, just for some of the guys on the staff, they're kind of curious. I heard some talking around here when you mentioned warning signs. Mm-hmm. For the guys that are curious, what are some of the warning signs?
Well, you know, when your girlfriend stops coming to bed, like, dressed in the nude, and she starts coming to bed, like, dressed as though she's headed off on an Arctic trek with, like, big, thick sweatpants and big, woolly sweaters and possibly some mittens.
Flannel is a bad thing? You're saying flannel is a bad thing?
Definitely. Definitely the layered look is not good.
You know, what else?
Well, maybe she goes out and she buys, like, a whole, like, a number of outfits. You know, it's very slinky outfits. Body-fitting, you know, outfits, but she just never wears them when you're around. She saves them for those girls' nights out, which seem to be occurring like 3 times a week.
Uh-huh. This is good. Are you guys learning anything from this? What else? Anything else? Those are pretty good signs.
Okay, if you go away for, you know, a 3-week business trip, mm-hmm. and when you come back, she looks at you and says, "Back already?" Not a good sign.
Not a good sign. What's next for you? Here we have about 30 seconds left. What are you working on now?
My co-author and I are actually working on a screenplay. It's a romantic comedy, and it involves Hollywood and Washington. And you'll be surprised to know that nobody gets dumped.
Nobody gets dumped. Happy ending, nice things.
Yes.
No passive aggressive, no nothing.
No.
Okay. All right, well, best of luck to you.
Thank
Very
you.
Very funny book.
Thank you.
Appreciate your time.
Okay,
the
bye-bye.
The book is called How to Dump a Guy, A Coward's Manual. And Lodowski has been our guest today. You're watching World News Now.